total freedom from stagnation. Total freedom. When we're talking about total, it means you will not go or get into another. When we're talking of freedom, that means you are free. How many people deserve freedom this morning? Shout, I'm free.
So that I will move.
Declare it that I am free. And when we're talking about stagnation, it means there is no progress or moving forward, and there is no going backward or retardation. That means the person is on a spot. If a water is stagnant and the water is not moving
slowly,
as much as many deaths therein, that would depict the level of the odor that will be coming from such water. Some people's life listening to me are likened to a stagnant water where people are putting deaths. And the life is giving different types of odor. Listen to me, sir. If a life of man is stagnated, his life will not be pleasing. The life of stagnation is not pleasing. It stinks.
It's
wound and sorrow of the heart. There's no man that desire to be stagnant. Everyone desires to progress. Whether you are a lawyer, or medical doctor, or a bishop, or a business person, or a student, every man desires progress. Anytime there's no progress in the life of a man, you will discover that there will be sorrow. It brings the bitterness of heart. Let me give you some setbacks.
Call it agony.
Let me give you some agonies that stagnation brings.
Pains.
Or pains. Thank you, sir. When a man's life is stagnated or is on a spot. If a man's life is on a spot.
Hey, imagine
someone that has a child.
Oh my,
and the child cannot walk.
Oh my,
the child cannot speak.
Oh, mama,
I was watching a mother that just finished her Thanksgiving. She came with some children. Those children, I remember that the first day she came with them. They are the same set of children. One of them will not talk. The child that is of age but cannot talk. The child was dumb. I was attending to people at the back of this place. And the morning came that these are my grandchildren. And the second child could not walk. I couldn't remember. Yes. Those are the two children that came forward with mama. One could not talk and one couldn't walk. We still have good mothers, likewise we have bad mothers. The mother took those children from her son that these are my grandchildren, give them to me. She was not a member. In fact, she's ordained in a church. But she believed as the body of Christ we are one. And she believed in prophetic ministry. She told her son that, please give me these children. I have a prophet I do follow. I believe in his God. That his God can do anything. And she came with us. children. What the Lord asked me to do, I did.
Oh,
mama. I said, Mama, she will not be carrying this child again. This child will walk. And this one that couldn't talk, you will come and tell me that he's now an extrovert. When Mama was giving text and one was running forward, and Mama was holding his hand that please wait for me, and the one that couldn't talk before that was talking. This makes me to know that there is no man on earth that does not want progress from moving forward. The first pain or agony that stagnation brings is bitterness of heart, inner sorrow.
It's
by come outside and laugh, and people will rejoice, and he will rejoice likewise. But whenever he's alone, he will cry, because there is fire that is burning underneath his garment. Bitterness of heart, sorrow of the heart, sorrow that you cannot express or tell people. The second pain is bring secret weeping. Stagnation brings secret weeping. You will seek the Lord and you will just consider examining your life. You will consider those that agments with you. Look at me, what is befitting is good. At that particular time that you have to achieve something and you did not achieve, then it is not good. Many people are waiting for God's time unknowingly that they are behind. That is why you need to be prepared. The life of stagnation brings about secret weeping, especially when you are lonely.
Oh,
you will not be able to express yourself. And even if you tell some people, they will mock or ridicule you. Some people that you confided in for solution, my friend, I'm keeping this secret with you, you will just discover that your secret is announced publicly. Then you will be crying and weeping. You will just be using powder or makeup to package yourself. You'll be laughing outside in order to package. But when you are alone, you'll begin to cry. As many that cry secretly, I don't know who the Lord sent me to this house. I want you to chop up this
and
say, as many that weep secretly, I promise
pẹ̀lú àṣẹ Jésù, bí o bá rí àmì mẹ́ta ṣe, ẹ kú ìkọ̀kọ̀ rẹ kó di ayé.
Owó wà nù nǹkan tí ìfẹ́ fi dúró rákẹ́, I love you, I love you, tí o bá lówó nù mọ̀mọ́, a gbọ́ result láìpẹ́.
Money is part of love. If a man has no money, he will later hear the result of where he belongs.
Ẹyin ọkùnrin tẹ wà bí atóbìnrin tẹ wà bí Ọlọ́run ni yọrọ owó, ọ̀rọ̀ owó kù nù ọ̀rọ̀ yín o.
Amen.
Ẹnìkan ní tó máa lówó jù ń lọrùn àpadì tó.
Men and women here present, may you not lack money. But if you believe that if you are rich or if you are wealthy, you will go to hellfire.
Owó kọ́ ni ìfẹ́, owó kọ́ ni ìfẹ́, òótọ́ ni, but owó yẹ kó wà lára ìfẹ́.
Money is not love. Money is love. Money is not love. It is true. But money is supposed to be part of love.
Nígbà tó bá yẹ kọ́ ọmọkùnrin lọ́wọ́ yọ kí ọmọ mi gba owó school.
When a man supposed to give school fees?
To ya ko so fun ya pe lo mo like aso ti mo ri lara lagbaja lo ran ru e gba owo.
Oh, give his wife money to go and make so clothes because he saw it somewhere. Collect this money.
Ti o si aye.
But there is no chance.
Ti landlord n kan ku pe show mo ko ti je mi lowo.
And landlord is knocking to collect rent.
Ti won sanwo olode ladugo.
And they are paying for security.
Ti won sanwo NEPA.
They are paying for light.
tí ò rí san.
And the man cannot pay.
Ẹyin obìnrin máa ń rò pé ọkùnrin ò fi concern torí pé wọn à fẹ́ sunkún wọn síta ni wọn máa ń dẹ ẹkún tí wọn sun ní
kọkọ. At times we just conclude that this man is not feeling the heat. It's not true. The reason is that men do cry secretly.
Ẹ ṣàmì.
Say amen.
Gbogbo ẹni tẹ́ ń sun ẹkún ìkọ̀kọ̀.
As many that cry secretly.
Ẹkún tó lè sun jáde síta.
What you cannot expose outside.
Gbogbo ẹyin tẹ ń da ẹkún sun ní kọ̀kọ̀.
As many that cry in loneliness.
Nítorí pé ẹwọ́ gbogbo ẹ̀rí pé ojú kan ló dúró
sí. Because you consider everything to be stopped.
Mo sọ tẹ́lẹ̀ bí wo bí. Pẹ̀lú àṣẹ Jésù. Ẹkún yẹ kó di ayọ̀ lọ́sẹ̀ yìí.
Ìgbé ayé kẹta tí ojú kan máa oró kẹta tí ìgbé ayé ojú kan máa ń dá ènìyàn.
And the third agony is.
Ó máa mú kéèyàn tọrọ lọ́wọ́ ẹni tí ò yẹ kó ti tọrọ.
It makes a man to beg where he's supposed not to beg.
Wa ma fi style be ni ti o ye ko be.
You will be begging stylishly.
Oh, ni mind the insult.
You will not mind or consider insults.
Oh, ni mind anything.
You will not mind anything.
Wa sha fagidi lo toro lowo en ti o ye ko.
Stylishly or cunningly, you will be begging.
Gbogbo ẹni tẹ wà ń bí.
As many present here.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ bẹ́ẹ̀ rábùrú yín ẹ jẹ.
That if you don't beg from your younger ones, you cannot feed.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ fọgbọ́n bẹ̀bẹ̀ lọ́wọ́ ọmọ inú yín ẹ lè survive.
If you don't beg stylishly from your younger ones, you cannot survive.
Orí jòkó ni kò ti ṣàmì
yẹn. On your sin shall amen.
Láti ìṣẹ́jú ìlú.
From this moment then.
Ayé ìtàrẹ padà.
Amen. The Lord change your story, amen. It makes man to beg where he's supposed not to beg. The fourth one. It hinders man from having a say.
Family by.
When they call family meeting. Oh, we want to do this burial.
I need the 1 million.
We need a million naira.
Ah!
You will be the one to
fall.
Ah! Hey! Because he doesn't have.
Well, the last born.
It might be the last one of the family.
And
he said, my brother can't. Oh, we can't pay such amount of money. It's too much.
But then it's true.
My brother, please be calm.
She be 1 million.
It's just a millionaire we're talking about.
What's the problem?
There's no problem.
Oh,
don't tell me to be calm. Don't tell me to be calm.
My
brother, I ask you to be quiet. I will leave this meeting for you. Because he realized that it's the younger brother that is paying for his children's school fees.
I need to return you.
He will say, I'm getting calm because of you. I will not make trouble for your sake.
Auntie me.
My sister.
Badami.
My brother. This money they shared for us. Don't worry, I will pay it alone. And if you're going back, I will give you your transport fare.
Amen.
That is the level the Lord will bless you. Oh, he will now praise
him. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I can vouch for
you. Me.
Next time.
But that is like copy.
That man is the first one. If they want to declare something about the family, the first one will now say, oh, we cannot do anything except this. My brother is present. In fact, I don't have a say. Many are of age, but they don't have what they ought to have. As many people in this condition, where you ought to have a say, stagnation did not allow you to have a say. Your life is ours today. Amen. Be seated. It Indus man from Avlin is saying, what is another agony of stagnation? Is Indus man from meeting up with his mate? Is Indus man from meeting up?
I refused
to
on a spot.
That you are not juko.
Stagnance is not my portion.
Stagnation makes a man a liar.
In fact,
you'll be lying in order to package your words. Obedience. They use it to stagnate man.
Number 10.
10.
Igberaga.
Pride. They use it to stagnate.
Number 11.
11.
Ikwaitojo.
Untimely death. They use it to stagnate man. Last week, Sunday, I explained 2 out of 11 points. How many of you remember the explanation? Which 2 did I explain?
Ori buruku ati kini ati aisan obere kan benu welu kori ke wa ese ketala.
There is a woman in Luke chapter 10
verse 13 money o size of 18 years.
She was sick for 18 years.
Bibeli pe o sick for 18 years.
The Bible says she was sick for 18 years.
Listen carefully to me. The greatest wealth on earth. The greatest wealth. It is not how many cars you have in your
pocket.
Listen carefully to me. The greatest wealth on earth.
Not
how many houses you have in the entire world.
No.
The greatest wealth on earth.
Not
that kind of huge amount of money you save somewhere. Either in the bank. Or as investment. It is not the greatest wealth. Listen and look here. The greatest wealth on earth is your head. The moment you lost your head, you forget your vision. You forget your dream. You forget whatever. In fact, you are ready to allow everything to go. In the plane one day, suddenly, a woman was screaming, God, take everything. Take everything you have given me. Give me back my health. By the time the plane landed, the car, the vehicle that came to pick up the
man,
from the tarmac, when others have to trek and go and clear themselves, VIP vehicle, with wheelchair, and they put a lot of wire in mama's body. Big woman with a lot of money but no health, no sound health. That is why you must not allow enemy to stop you with sickness.
Oh, good old back here, that your fear is a coffee called war.
If you look at that passage, Luke chapter 10, verse 13.
Luke, what is the Ketala?
The Bible says the woman was afflicted with sickness for 18 years.
Oh, Billy, he only a fear is a follow you for the
engineer. To the extent that she became bent.
Titi of it,
yes. 18.
We
don't know her age. Add 18 to her age. That means she
couldn't go to work. She couldn't sell or trade. She couldn't do many things that she desired. Look at me, I was once sick.
Wọ́n máa sún jẹ tó dùn kalẹ̀ báyìí tá ìsẹ̀ bá dé kí ló máa ṣe lẹ́nu èèyàn.
They will prepare delicious meal but you will not have appetite.
Ẹgbọ́ sá.
Listen to me. They will prepare different types of food, you will not have appetite. Your mouth will be bitter.
Mo rọ ọmọ mi tí Ọlọ́run wò sànú cancer láàárọ̀ yìí. Ó ṣe voice note sí mi níjẹta, ó lóun lọ sí hospital for check-up.
Hallelujah.
Doctor, you may be madam. Change one.
When she got to hospital this week Friday, the doctor asked her,
Madam, are you still alive? Are you still alive?
Imagine doctor asking patient.
Ewa wo ki dokita ko ma bere lowo alaisan. Pe so si wa laye?
Awa ro ko ti ku.
We thought you are late or you are dead already.
Mi o mo report to ti gba.
I don't know the type of medical report you have.
O ti eniyan ti so si aye.
I don't know the conclusion of men against.
Oh, come on yo pada.
But there is a voice that
ashe come on yo ro pada. O ko ta solo di si aye e. To bu ko ma ronu pe boyo peti de. Mo so tolo fo so ka same aye pada nla pa lara.
I declare into your life that there be great transformation this morning. Be seated. Are you still alive? And what was your response? I told them that I would not die.
Look at the confidence.
But live. And worry that you not dream. Doctor, that was your conclusion that I'm going to die. But that's not the word of God concerning me. The doctor was amazed looking at her miraculously.
The same doctor to so pe so si wa ni.
Dokita to bere pe are you still alive?
O ye ko ti ku.
You supposed to have died.
O na lo so pe o ni the hospital mo.
Was the word that confirmed her total healing.
O ti sapata pata.
She is totally healed.
Abroad, don't be
telling my belly. How many of you desire to travel out of this country and to be living abroad. Shout hallelujah.
Very good.
Those of you that you want to stay there, and those of us that want to be going and coming. Amen. It should be possible for us. Amen. All our members are just traveling.
In Canada, America.
Canada, America, UK. And I want us to be complaining that Lord, what is happening? The Lord said, you pray for them. And he answered,
honestly, within the space of 6 months, all my joy to travel out. Family, no, family.
We have families in this church that travel out. I met some people when I traveled to UK, to US.
That's nice.
Money and not doubt that. If we are all at the spot, nobody is moving because they marry, nobody moves because they have a new job, nobody travel abroad, that means our prayers are not answered. Please be truthful.
No, born again, sister. Oh,
if Otedola's son should toast you, and a farmer's son somewhere in the village is toasting you, who are you going to say yes to? Whether you are a born again sister or not.
Sisters
here, if you desire your husband to be jobless, you want to be feeding him, you want to be clothing him, you want to be giving him transport money. Shout hallelujah. No sister is shouting hallelujah.
America, tobacco in America, go to the UK, tobacco in the UK. And it's a fair hallelujah.
Our sisters in this auditorium, if you desire your husband to be buying vacation tickets to be taking you from US to UK to Dubai to Canada, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I thought that as born again sisters, you don't need all these things.
Listen to me.
It is good for us to seek first the kingdom of God. For us to test about heaven. To focus on not losing heaven. But on it.
It's
good to beg God. Everything needed to live successfully on this
earth.
That the Lord should give those things to me.
I read a place in the Bible. Ecclesiastes chapter 9. And the Bible says there was a particular community. There's a town which is having a problem. And that country have a very poor wise man. Very poor wise man. And by his wisdom, he delivered that country from calamity. But the Bible says he was forgotten.
The Bible says wisdom is a defense.
And if you want to diabo.
Likewise, money is a defense. defense.
Ani.
Likewise.
Gege bi owo ti je.
Abo.
Money is a defense.
Ya jo mi gba ya ni o le ki ja un completed building.
My matron then when she was alive would say a thief cannot steal from uncompleted
building. O ni o ti mo pe ko le si kankan be ko kilo be lo ko be.
Since there is nothing tangible there is nothing to steal.
But if you
see the house of a wealthy man,
yeah, only fence.
Apart from fence,
and the CCTV.
There will be CCTV.
Yeah, only CCTV.
Apart from CCTV, there will be security.
Huh?
Apart from guards,
through
some technological gadgets, you can see, even when you are not at home, you can see everything going on in your house. Will you have 50,000 and install all these gadgets we're talking about? Tell someone. By your side, I'm not poor. As from today, if they don't get well in my family, I your bridges, I will be wealthy, I'll be very rich spiritually, physically, financially, and in all
areas. Money is a defense. Money is honor.
Ola oni owo.
Because
you will see.
I will never be poor. Please, ministry. Without money, I'm telling you, nothing will happen there. Utol and so for a while.
Most of that for you, Ishe, Russia, like so, what was so to my shell and bed?
Oh, Babylon radio, oh, Babylon television, only below the social media, whichever, only lowly post out, be bought duo. A shell go out, I'll buy up any of your role, and yet, Amazon, love it.
You saw
money.
You heard our jingles on the radio. You saw us on television, on social media. You saw our billboard. You saw everything we distributed. Are we going to go to radio station and say we are anointed of God? Don't collect money. No, we are spending money.
We are. They are praying for people, preaching to people, and they don't take offering again. Or he's telling you that don't pay tithe again. It means Olorun ti raise awon eyan fun. Kawo pe daddy se. Boss le la vera emi nikan ma ra daddy she so pa fe lo ko first story sibi kan awa mewa ma ko
amen
eh won ti ni niyan in the beginning of the ministry it wasn't like that.
Okay, if you see a ministry where they are not collecting offering or tithe, it's because some people are bearing the burden, some people are volunteers. In the beginning of the ministry it was not like that.
Look at it.
Ewo bi o
flag iboli.
Which flag is this?
Hello, me go. That can come.
Oh, some people, you don't go, even the
flag.
Since in your village you don't have flag, where is this?
Eh?
USA. How many of us are going there?
Iboni.
This one is where?
Iboni.
This one called?
Eh?
China.
Kari. Ibinko.
This one called?
Eh? Elenko.
Canada.
Elenko.
This blue,
France.
White, and red.
Elenko.
France.
Germany.
This one. Germany, not
do you know what?
Shemonko.
1 year.
Ni aduka.
I was praying.
Mongo adura.
In my village.
Ninu abule mi ni abami.
In Iseorun.
Ni Iseorun.
I was telling people, I said, if God raised you in Ibadan, if God raised you in Lagos, and God now raised me from Orun.
Oh, most of our way, Talon Bagio, the Denibad, the Togio, the Deneco, and Mitoa, the Deni or who?
And we are now operating at almost same level.
Our John Shani Peleka now.
I think I'm better off you.
Ah, Morope, was she that I do all of
you? Cop your mind. You do not want to struggle to pay school fees.
Oh, Fetra Kalati is away.
You don't want to struggle to travel anywhere anymore.
Oh, Fetra Kalati,
you don't want to struggle to do anything on earth.
Oh, Fetra Kalati, show God.
God must open door for you.
And
it begins from your mind.
o si bere lati inu okan re wa
gbogbo nkan ti mo nto ti mo ba nto jo mi o se je ma se mo le se kekeke flag kekeke igba mi gan mo lo se oni leather to ya in ti mo ba so fọlọrun ni pe gbogbo awon mo ipe yi ni ko fun laye
amen
ha ni origun merin aye ni ko fun laye.
All these big mouths that you are seeing here, this is not the first time. In fact, I've started with this small, small mouth. At times, there was a time I made leather mouth because I prayed to God that God will open doors to all members of this ministry all over the world. And the Lord has started. Amen. Amen.
Oh, my God.
Amen.
I never feel no so you can.
Lack stagnates man. I was speaking with one of my friends. He's older. I said, sir, please don't be offended. How old are you?
Money, I'm 62.
He said, oh, but you mentioned God, sir. I said, where do you want to spend the remaining years of your life? He said, what do you mean? Don't let me move with the wrong person. Some people miss this in life because they move with a wrong set of people.
Program is not a program.